Mayor of Christiansburg. Please stand with me as we pledge the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. This is a very special day in the history of Christiansburg. We're here this evening to recognize some outstanding young athletes, either teams that have won state championships, or we're recognizing individuals who've won state championships. And I know that our wrestling team and our basketball team has another place they need to be right now. So we'll go ahead and begin the program with Councilman Brad Stipes recognizing our basketball team, be followed by Councilman Cord Hall, who will honor our wrestling team. Councilman Van Hoosier will recognize the individual wrestling champions. And then we'll have Showalter, our councilman, to recognize our football team. And then the academic team will be recognized by Mr. Steve Huppert. And in between, Councilman Barber is going to present some awards for our 4x800 champion track team. Mr. Stipes.
It's a great time to be a Christiansburg fan, isn't it? We're very proud of our accomplishments this year. In fact, the mayor had sent out an email earlier this week and said we needed to consider putting a sign at the town hall that says, "Welcome to Christiansburg, home of state champions." So we'll see what comes of that. That may have been political manner, I'm not sure. A few brief words. I would like to invite the Coach Good, Coach Lewis, and Coach Cooper if they're here. I didn't see Coach Cooper. Maybe he is here. I'd like to have the coaches come up and also the state champion basketball team to come up here, please.
Tell everybody who I want.
Line up here so everyone can see you. See what a state champion looks like. Okay. Instead of using my own words this evening before we read the resolution, which I could go on and on about, I'm using words of other people to tell the story about the last couple years. Roanoke Times, 2011, last year, January, talks about Coach Good and his attitude as a servant leader and his humility on his team's improvement from last year when it went 12-10 and 3-7 in the district. "I just think the kids got better. I can't say that I'm doing anything. I just think they got better. They played all summer long. They worked on their game. I've got a couple of guys that I've got to tell them to get out of the gym, and that's a good thing." Last year, not this year. Again, last year, January 2011, Kevin Cox, who's a graduated senior, on his team's early roll, "Coach really puts us in check and doesn't let us get too hot-headed. He says we need to go 1-0 every night. He stole it from Coach Cromer in football, but when he says it, he means it." That was last year. I think they all mean it this year. Well, I think he's always meant it, but I want to credit Kevin with that, Coach. Coach Good's tweet, I've never tweeted, but my sons do. Coach Good's tweet following the state quarterfinal game on March 3rd this year against Amherst at the Salem Civic Center. This was on Sunday morning. Coach Good's tweet, "To God be the glory. Always remember where your blessings come from. And we were eating lunch on Sunday, and my boys told me that by noon on Sunday, it had already been retweeted 5 times and favorited twice. And apparently that's pretty good. I don't know about tweets, but... And probably the best one of all is from the Roanoke Times, Ray Cox, on March 16th. This is an excerpt. "The guys celebrated the right way, the respectful way, the good way. In other words, they were sportsmen in the best sense of the word." And you can look at them and see they're nice, fine young men.
Thank you.
As for Coach Sean Good of Christiansburg, with a hearty assist from football boss Tim Cromer, not to mention a regiment of parents, a tone was set from the top. That's where the coach started in his public remarks after the basketball nets had been sliced at the top. He gave thanks to God. "You'd expect reverence from the son and brother of coaches. Good said that winning the state was the greatest feeling he'd ever had. That from a guy who played on a national invitational tournament champion team, I believe that was 95. No comparison," he said. And also in showing empathy, I'm going to recognize Joey Augustine. It's in the same article from Ray Cox. "That's the way it was when Grafton coached, which was the state final on March 10th. Grafton coach Jeremy Jordan stuck around with 3 dry-eyed players until closing in on 1 a.m., with each of them talking in turn to a small group of media after an epic 1-point overtime heartbreak against Christiansburg. We know how they feel, losing so close," said empathetic Blue Demon Joey Augustine, one of a number of football players who had to snap too quick for round ball this season after losing by only 2 points in the football final this year. "Most important line of the evening: class is something you can't buy, can't fake, or pull out of the closet for special occasions. And that's what this team has, is class." It is my distinct honor to read this resolution to each of you. And I wish your wife was here, number one fan. Kelly, she's not here, is she? Okay. "Whereas Christiansburg High School was provided opportunities for students to participate in a comprehensive sports program as part of the overall sports program, or overall program of studies during its long history. Whereas competitive basketball for girls and boys complements the overall sports program and is governed by the Virginia VHSL, making it possible for students to excel in sports at the district, regional, state levels. And whereas Christiansburg High School has fielded many exceptional basketball teams over the years, giving coaches, students, and local residents an opportunity to enjoy the game and learn life lessons from the competitive nature of the game. And whereas basketball at Christiansburg High School has given former players opportunity for college scholarships and an opportunity to participate at the collegiate level, and we have several examples of that here this evening. And that's probably Coach Good's number one goal, is to see them move on with their education. Whereas the 2011-2012 Christiansburg High School basketball team has carried out the long-established tradition of success, winning the River Ridge District Championship and the Region 4 Championship. And whereas the basketball team earned the right to participate in the VHSL State Championship playoffs held in Richmond in March 2012. And whereas the basketball team was named the Group 4 state champions by winning the final game in overtime on March 10th, 2012 in Richmond. And whereas the achievements of the 2011-2012 CHS basketball team brought favorable recognition to the school district, River Ridge District, and the reason you're here tonight, to the residents of the town of Christiansburg. Now, therefore be resolved that the Christiansburg Town Council meeting in regular session, March 20th, 2012, adopted this resolution and hereby expresses our congratulations and appreciation to the coaching staff and members of the basketball team for an outstanding season. We extend our heartfelt best wishes for continued success." And it's signed Mayor Richard G. Ballinger. So I'll present this to Coach Good. Thank you.
I'll scoot down.
Congratulations.
That's a tough act to follow, I would imagine. A lot of the things that Mr. Stites mentioned today about the basketball team, I think, can also be used to describe members of the Christiansburg wrestling team. I get made fun of because of my accent. I'm from this area and just got to live with it. It's the way I talk. But the wrestling team, under the leadership of Coach Darryl Weber, you know, it's almost one of those things where if you hear like that, if they don't win a championship or state championship, you think, what happened? The expectation is so great on these young men, and every year they rise to the occasion, and every year they continue to set the bar higher and higher. But the aspects that Mr. Sipes mentioned about the basketball team, class and humility, I think also demonstrates a bit demonstrative of these individuals year in and year out. It's been a pleasure watching them succeed in the areas of Grundy, enjoyed those matches down there, enjoyed the state championships, and it just, it's remarkable. It's an incredible feat, and one that it's awful tough to match. At this time, if I could ask Coach Weber to come forward, wherever he's located, and if I could also have the members of the wrestling team go ahead and come forward as well, please. Humility. I've got a list of accolades I could probably read in the next 3 or 4 hours on this group of men. This individual probably would rather me not do that. It's a team effort at all times in his book, and I honestly think that Coach Webb would be somewhat embarrassed if I continue to say all the great things about him, so I'm not going to do it. I won't embarrass him too much. However, I would like to mention a few things. Number one, Coach Webb was the Southwest Regional Coach of the Year this past year. WIN Magazine, which is also WinMagazine.com, this is the number 8 ranked national team that's in front of you tonight. Of all the teams across the country, they're 8. And just a few other statistics. 11 straight state championships, 14 straight district and regional championships, 4 nationally ranked wrestlers in front of you this evening, 6 state champions in front of you, 10 state placers, 12 state qualifiers. I don't believe there's a single locality in the state of Virginia, the Commonwealth, that can compete with that. And maybe most importantly, and I think that Brad hit upon this as well with Coach Good and the seniors, there's 3 seniors here tonight, and go ahead and step forward if you don't mind. Tyler Miles, Ryan Wade, and Brandon Taylor. All 3 seniors in the wrestling team in Christiansburg have already committed to college and universities. The tradition of excellence, I think, has been exemplified by Coach Weber at the high school level. I imagine they're going to carry over to the collegiate level. Again, there's not a single person graduating from this team that's not going on to college. I believe that, correct me if I'm wrong, which one of you is going to Virginia Tech? And 2 are going to Limestone College, correct? All right. One last thing as well. This is part of the, I went to Crisper High School. We didn't have quite the success that's here tonight. Henry, a lot of us went to Crisper High School. This truly is the golden age of Crisper athletics and academics. Make no mistake. I know I stepped on some toes when I said that. There's a lot of people that played sports here in the room. But you didn't play this good. You didn't excel this good. I'm trying to remember, we had a state champion. And we always used to say that my brother Shane played football. I think they were the regional runners-up, the regional champion or something. We used to hang our hat on that for football. Sorry, Shane. State champions are here tonight. It's amazing how good we've become. This being the case, I'd like to go ahead and read a resolution on behalf of Coach Weber and the team. And then following this, Mr. Van Hoosier is going to award some individual awards to these individual members of the wrestling team. That being said, whereas the Christopher High School wrestling team has once again been victorious, distinguishing itself at the Virginia State AA Championship wrestling match held in Salem, Virginia. And whereas the Christenberg wrestling team has sustained a record of winning the state championship, having won for the years 2002 through 2012. And whereas this record of accomplishment in winning the state championship for 11 consecutive years has brought favorable recognition to the Christenberg High School, its coaches, and wrestling team members, and to the community as a whole. And whereas six individual student wrestlers distinguished themselves at the VHSL state championships in their weight classifications, now therefore be it resolved that the town council of the town of Christopher, meeting in regular session on March 20, 2012, hereby expresses its congratulations and appreciation to Coach Darrell Weber and all members of the Christopher High School wrestling team for their continued outstanding performance in the Virginia State AA Championship wrestling match, and we extend our best wishes for continued success. Congratulations.
Six of them there. Thank you. We appreciate everyone else being here, and I'm going to make some awards to these gentlemen. And they're brief, so I'll read each and every one of them. This certificate hereby recognizes Coy Azale for his exemplary performance at the 2012 VHSL Group AA State Championship and capture of the state title in the 106-pound weight class. Your performance brought favorable recognition to town of Christiansburg, and your efforts are to be commended. This is conveyed on the 17th day of April 2012, and it's signed for Richard, Mountain View Mayor, and Town Manager Barry Hams. Congratulations. This certificate hereby recognizes J.R. Work for his exemplary performance at the 2012 VHSL Group AA State Championship and capture of the state title in the 120-pound weight class. Your performance brought favorable recognition to the town of Christiansburg, and your efforts are to be commended. Conveyed on the 17th day of April, 2012. This certificate hereby recognizes Joy Dams for his exemplary performance at the 2012 VHSL Group AA State Championship and capture of the state title in the 132-pound weight class. Your performance brought favorable recognition to the town of Christiansburg, and your efforts will be commended. Conveyed on the 17th day of April, 2012. Congratulations. This certificate hereby recognizes Dallas Smith for his exemplary performance at the 2012 BHSL Group AA State Championship and captured the state title in the 138-pound weight class. Your performance brought favorable recognition to the town of Christiansburg, and your efforts are to be commended. Conveyed on this 17th day of April 2012. This certificate hereby recognizes Zach Everly for his exemplary performance at the 2012 BHSL Group AA State Championship and captured the state title in the 160-pound weight class. Your performance brought favorable recognition to the town of Christiansburg, and your efforts are to be commended. Conveyed on the 17th day of April 2012. This certificate hereby recognizes Tyler Miles for his exemplary performance at the 2012 BHSL Group AA State Championship and capture of the state title in the 170-pound weight class. Your performance brought favorable recognition to the town of Christiansburg, and your efforts are to be commended. Conveyed on the 17th day of April 2012.
Success I had back in 88 was
the cross-country team won districts. Of course, we didn't place the states or regions, but that was a big deal back then. I know that when I knew that Timmy Kramer had become the head coach at Christiansburg High School, and the team that he put together, these coaches, and I knew there's a lot of character there, and I knew good things were yet to come. I think this was a very successful season and a good stepping stone. And one of the things when you hear about fiscal budgets, you hear about that a lot. When I look at a community, I look at the health of the community and the progression of the community. And I weigh that a lot on our youth. And if you see what Christiansburg has done recently, in the past few years, I mean, the resolutions you've seen tonight are catalysts to this community being sustainable and successful. So I want to congratulate you all on that as well. But before I read the resolution, we've heard a lot about the athletes and the coaches tonight, and the ones who do the hard work, but let's also remember the unsung heroes, the volunteers, the teachers, the administration, the trainers, the mentors, either at your church or through the guidance at the school, and most important, the parents. So I'd like to give a round of applause for the parents tonight for working so hard. Players and coaches, congratulations on your accomplishment, and we're going to get to this resolution. Timmy had promised me that if I run out of breath, he'll finish it up for me. Whereas a competitive football program at Christiansburg High School has contributed to the overall development of physical as well as the mental attributes of young athletes for the long history of Christiansburg High School. And whereas Christiansburg High School has filled an exceptional organized football program since the formation of the Virginia High School League, District 6, New River District, Blue Ridge District, and the River Ridge District. And whereas there's been many great football teams throughout the years at Christiansburg High School, thus giving notable former coaches, Christiansburg residents, as well as state and national citizens, an opportunity to participate as student athletes and excel successfully in the game. And whereas the 2011 Christiansburg football team was named River Ridge District and Region 4 champion, and whereas the 2011 CHS football team achieved an unprecedented right to represent the River Ridge District in Region 4 in the Virginia High School League Group AA state championship game held at Broadway, Virginia. And whereas the 2011 Christiansburg football team was named VHSL, Virginia State Football Runners Up, the state champion after a very close contest. And whereas the coaching staff and members of the 2011 CHS football team instilled pride in their community, brought honorable and favorable recognition to their school as well as to the residents and town officials of the town of Christiansburg. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Christiansburg Town Council meeting in regular session, March 20th, 2012, adopted this resolution in recognition of the 2011 CHS football team exceptional season and three consecutive River Ridge District and Region 4 championships, as well as state runner-up champions, and extend our sincerest best wishes for continued success. Congratulations. Coach Cromer to say a little bit about his players, the season, and of course his coaching staff.
Thank you. I do accept this on behalf of our coaching staff and players. Thank you, Mayor Ballinger and Town Council, for this recognition. Unfortunately, we did not win a state championship, but we did have the most successful season in the history of our school. We were 12-1. We won 8 straight games. We lost one. And we're 12-2, I think, in fact. And we won 4 games and lost the championship game. But I did want to point out 2 things that I think our town can be very proud of. First of all, our program, you'll notice that our football team, we dressed 55 in the state championship game. We've only got about 8 guys up here, and that's because the majority of our football players play other sports. 9 guys with the basketball team. We've got guys playing baseball tonight, guys involved in other things. And I just truly believe in the multi-sport athlete, and I think that that's how our program survives. And I want to thank, in particular, Coach Good and Coach Gwynn. And I think our coaching staff believes in teamwork. I think they believe, and I talk about our school coaching staff, understand sharing athletes and how important it is. And we certainly, if Coach Good, I say this, they mention football a lot because basketball season comes after football season, but there's no way that we would have been as successful as we were if Coach Good did not support us, because we had basically 9 of his 13 varsity basketball players with us until December 10th. That's a month after the season had started. And then those guys still won 28 ball games and won a state championship. So that just tells you the quality of our coaching staff and our players. One thing I want to point out is this senior class is the greatest athletic class to ever come through Christiansburg High School, without a doubt. And all the classes underneath have supported them. And the greatest thing about our football team was it was the most talented football team in history, but their character and how they acted in school and the fact that they did not get in trouble, it was the greatest joy for us to coach, was to coach this team. So I just wanted to say that because I wanted our town to know that there's a lot to be proud of. And I said when we were hired, I say it all the time, we wanted to put a product on the field that our town can be proud of, and I think we've done that. It's because of our players. So thank y'all very much. I appreciate that.
City to compete in higher competitions. I mean, this guy, I see sweating every morning when I'm driving to work in air conditioning, and he's running with the kids. I said, God, this guy must be nuts. But anyway, he's a coach, he leads by example, and we all should be very proud to have a gentleman like Shane to head up one of our programs, or two of our programs, or three. What do you have, cross-country, boys and girls track?
Indoor track and outdoor track.
Indoor track and outdoor track. Okay.
Well, he runs all the time.
Yeah, he does. He does, exactly. Okay. What I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to present individual awards to four young ladies that won, and I'm going to read this one time, and then I will call each of the girls up individually to receive, because I watched everybody else read 10 of those things. I said, I'm not doing it. I'm going to read one, then I'm going to single out each girl. For her exemplary performance at the 2012 Virginia High School League AA State Championships and capture of the state title in girls 4x800-meter relay, your performance brought favorable recognition to the town of Christiansburg, and your efforts are to be commended. Conveyed this 17th day of April 2012, signed by the Honorable Mayor Richard Ballingy and our town manager Barry Helms, Cassie Lincas. Rachel Bishop. Megan Burns. And last, certainly not least, this is our Eliza Eaton.
Yay.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the individual members of a team championship, our 4x800 track.
I should have known better than to let these councilmen present the awards. A lot of stuff what they said certainly weren't written on the plaque itself. In Councilman Hall, I came to Christiansburg in 1963 to teach at Christiansburg High School, and I also did some coaching, but I never had a state champion. So you're exactly right. We've had programs for many years, but I don't think I have ever seen as much enthusiasm nor as much pride in the community as has been generated this year by these groups of young people. Congratulations to all of you. 3 weeks ago, we had a young lady appear before town council to receive an award and a resolution for setting a state record in the shot put, and also for establishing state championship in the discus throw. Then she went to New York City and she placed sixth in the nation and was designated an All-American. Tonight, it's my pleasure to present another certificate to Rochelle Evans. Rochelle, come up please, for her exemplary performance at the 2012. AA State Championship and capture the state title in the girls' shot put with a new group AA state record throw of 43 feet. This young lady is an All-American. She is also going to William and Mary College this fall on a full scholarship. Congratulations, Georgia. Excited us when we knew an academic team was doing well. And if the counselors this now are what they were before, the counselors are probably walking on air, as this team is not only number one here in the state of Virginia, but they're also ranked number 21 in the nation. And then on Memorial Day weekend, they're going to Atlanta for the national championship. And they all have been to numbers of different places. They competed at Duke University and competed at other places. And briefly right now, I would like Ms. Alderman just to introduce the members of our team.
We actually have a rather large team, but as Coach Kramer was saying earlier, the kids who are involved in a lot of things. And we too have kids that are participating in sports tonight and also participating in the musical practice, because a lot of our kids are also involved in the musical program at Christiansburg. Tonight we have Chris Lee, Kelsey Woolwine, Matt Fleischer, Matt Michella, and Steve Shelton, who are here with us tonight.
I would like, and I know everybody supports me on this, we hope that you guys have the very best of luck when you go down to Atlanta. And the role that Christiansburg is on right now, I'm not sure, you know, this could be the year to take it all. All right. Here's a resolution. Whereas a strong academic curriculum is vital to the effectiveness of a comprehensive high school, and whereas Christiansburg High School offers an academic challenge to its students in all major disciplines, including foreign languages, career and technical education, and fine arts. And whereas Christiansburg High School students have participated successfully in the Virginia High School League Scholastic Bowl for many years, thus establishing a record of academic excellence. And whereas in 2011-2012, the Scholastic Bowl team earned a record of 21 wins and only 5 losses in competing with other high schools in the Blue Ridge District and Region 4. And whereas the CHS Scholastic team came from behind to score 3 consecutive matches to propel them to the final round of the VHL tournament. And whereas the CHS team was named Virginia High School League State Runner-Up Champions in the tournament held in Williamsburg, Virginia on February 25th, 2012. And whereas the accomplishments brought favorable recognition and pride to the Christiansburg High School and to the town of Christiansburg. Now, therefore, be it resolved, the Christiansburg Town Council meeting in regular session on March 20th, 2012 adopted the resolution
in appreciation and congratulations to the CHS Academic Scholastic Bowl team with sincere wishes of best luck in their future endeavors. Congratulations to all of you. And Clerk of Court, Michelle Stikes. All right, congratulations, Bob.
I didn't want to leave anyone out, so a couple people I need to remember to acknowledge. I co-coached this team with Suzanne Shelburne, so it is not just, you know, my efforts, it is her efforts, but beyond everybody, it is the kids' efforts, because they sneak off and practice when we cancel practices and call hiatuses and say, okay, we need a little bit of break. So they are an incredibly determined group of kids. We also have a great deal of support from the parents of our students because they allow us to gather up their kids and trek them all over this part of the country. We take them up to West Virginia, to other parts of the state, down in North Carolina, and we compete in a lot of other places. And I did want to clarify, too, because Mr. Hubbard had mentioned that we're number one in the state, and then he said we were runner-up at the VHSL competition, and some people might be going, well, what does that mean? The academic competition team competes in a number of different conferences, not only Scholastic Bowl, but also the NAQT, which is the national tournament. And in that, we are ranked 21st in the nation. We're the highest-ranking team in the state of Virginia. That includes not only AA, AAA, single-A, private schools, public schools, magnet schools, charter schools. So it is it's great. We do look forward to continued support from the town. So thank you.
And your season is just not in the fall, it's a year-round season, is that correct?
Yeah, we go from August until May, yes. Right. I have to rush these kids back so they'll be here for graduation on the 29th because I'm taking them to Atlanta.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take about a 5-minute recess before we get into the regular program. Congratulations, young people. Parents, thank you so much for being here this evening. First public hearing was by Radford and Radford Properties. They have withdrawn their request for a public hearing. And the second agenda item was contingent upon the first, and they have also withdrawn their request for a conditional use permit. The third public hearing is a conditional use permit request by Cook's Auto Upgrades, acting as agent for property owner MTS Associates, for an automobile upholstery shop located at 575 North Franklin Street, tax parcels 496, 8, 51, and 52. This is in the B3 General Business District. Is there anyone here that would like to speak to this request?
Planning Commission has a recommendation. Do you want me to do that?
Are we going to do that this evening, or do
you
they come back?
You know what the recommendation is.
All right, but they'll be coming back to us in 2 weeks as a recommendation. I'd rather wait until then.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, is everybody familiar with exactly where this is located? And if you know where the old Arctic car thing, it's almost right across from where we are right now. And then there was a
carpet place,
was right behind that. And now this place that he is going to do is sort of to the right and a little bit behind it. And if you drive by it, and if you don't look for it, you will not see it. But it's back there in that corner. You can look for it when you go there tomorrow or something. Now, pretty well, Randy.
Yes, it's a former T&M Motors property.
Okay. Is it the rock? rods up on top of the hill.
That's what you'd use for the monster.
Well, it's sort of brownish, isn't it?
The reason I did not ask for that recommendation is we had people here earlier before the crowd got here that wanted to speak to the request, and I'd rather give them an opportunity to be heard before we hear the recommendation. Town Council is now in session. You have a copy in front of you of the minutes of the last meeting. Do I hear a motion to approve the minutes?
So moved.
Second.
Motion to approve the minutes. I'm sorry. All in favor of approval of the minutes, please say aye.
Aye.
Minutes are approved. I do have a proclamation. This came to us through New River Cares. Just a minute. Yeah, wouldn't you know that I don't have that proclamation with me, but it is proclaiming that April is child abuse prevention month. And that has been sent to the newspaper for publication, and I was pleased to proclaim April as child abuse prevention in Christiansburg. All right, now let's hear citizen comments. And I believe we have one citizen who wants to speak.
Yeah.
Two citizens, huh? Okay, we'll take the first one here. Ms. Dorson.
I have to turn this around because I have notes, and it's the effects of age. We're hoping we're going to be holding the second annual Depot Day on the 14th of July. We're already gearing up for it. And we right now have at least 9 booths already lined up, which is cool. Everybody from the Cambria Baptist Church will be back with their toy train set up. And we have a couple of different groups doing plant sales, and the 4-H and the Master Gardeners will be down there, as well. Sierra Club. I have a long list, but I left that sitting at the depot. But we hope to have both sides of the street, on both sides of the track, filled with booths. The one requirement, well, we normally don't charge a booth rent or space fee for this festival, because it's a community festival and it's free to the public. The one requirement we have is that every vendor, quote, has to have an activity for kids, every single one of them. I don't care if they, whatever else they do, they have to have an activity for kids. And last year, that was one of the things that made it a real success. We had 1,100 people show up for the first Depot Day Festival. So we're hoping we'll set more records this year, and as hoping by having it in the summer that it will be a positive thing. So I'm officially asking the Town Council once again to do exactly what we did last year with exactly the same format, which is close Cambria Street from Montgomery Street across to where it comes into Depot, and Depot from the back corner of Electrical Supply to essentially the beginning of the rail yard. And to notice the Cambria fire truck, which is the fire truck at the main station that has the depot on it. The fire and rescue people, the police department, they did a great job in terms of handing out DARE stuff and some other activity materials for kids, the public safety stuff. And also to Lowe's, the cones, the tape, and the vests so that we can cordon off the railroad track so we don't have any adults running out in front of the train. The children really aren't the problem with trains, it's the adults with cameras that we have to worry about. So we're making the same request this year. One request we do have is that this is being sponsored. The Civic League last year sponsored it. They decided, because it's a very small organization, they didn't want to do it again. So the sponsorship was picked up by essentially three merchant groups out of Cambria, Blue Ridge Heating and Air, Crabford Country Store, the Cambria Emporium Dealers, and Carol and I crossed the street at Depot. And so wanted to ask the town council and your application for grants to help cover the cost of asking to cover, close the street off. The original grant package asked that the grants be given only to nonprofits and to town or to government organizations. And we're asking if you could expand that to include groups of businesses when they step up and volunteer to throw a community fair. Thank you very much. We hope to see all of you there. And if you want to volunteer, we've got plenty of opportunities for volunteers.
Have you submitted the application?
It's going to vary by May 1st is what we agreed on.
Okay, I believe it's 45 days.
Yeah, well, you're actually getting it sooner this time because we didn't know about the 45 days last time, so we were actually a little beyond that deadline. This year, we're actually getting it in a month in advance, so this is a good thing.
So what it entails is closing the street, and there is some cost involved, which you're asking the Tourism Council to pick up.
I think that was the purpose of that grant. I can't remember exactly. It was helping bring the town costs.
But we are going to have to alter the requirement because it's been for non-profit organizations, right. And this time it's being sponsored by profit organizations.
Profit organizations, yeah. Like I said, it's sort of the merchants down there essentially have done hold it handy party. It's one of those, hey gangs, let's throw a fair. Well, rather than let's put on a play. But we decided that it was so successful last year. We all heard very positive comments, both from the neighborhood, from the folks who live in Cambria, and people who came back for it. We had a lot of out-of-towners, and all you have to do is look at the guest book that was sitting out at the depot. Last year we had nearly 400 of the 1,100 that we can account for. We may have had more than that, but we know 1,100, at least in terms of name. And about 400 of those were from outside of Christiansburg. And they came in and they had lunch at Amelia's or New South. They, in some cases, stayed over. In some cases, they also had dinner. They went shopping at the mall. They had, you know, there was a lot of activity that went on. So you get a fair amount of sales tax back and the meals tax revenues back from that. So there is a bit of an offset.
Okay, so you're asking two things.
I'm asking you to we're going to do exactly the same thing.
Right. First of all, you want it approved, and secondly,
you betcha, and the fact that you put your tourism brochure probably suggests that you will.
Yes.
I'm pitching my best there, but it was kind of listed for this year. Except two months later, we looked at May and thought there are so many other things going on that it was better to move it later and avoid the things like graduation season attack and Radford and all that. So we're putting it in the middle of summer. And we actually coordinated with Barry in conjunction with all the swim meets at the Aquatic Center, and pick the weekend with the smallest number of participants at the Aquatic Center. Because we thought, well, you know, we would pick one where there were lots and lots of cars with a huge participant base for the Aquatic Center and no parking. And while I do own a good portion of the parking in Cambria, it's not that big spaces, so.
All right, Council, we can either refer this to the street committee for a recommendation, or you can approve it tonight if you want to, but contingent upon the application, we do have a committee that reviews and makes recommendation on the funding.
Oh,
thank you.
Yeah.
Megan,
exchange the.
Yes, sir.
Blue Ridge Heating and Air.
Crab Creek Country Store. And the others.
Crab Creek.
Yes, that's the other half of Blue Ridge Heating and Air.
Oh, okay.
That's the gift shop part of the car store and the grill store.
Who else was it?
The folks over at the Emporium, the Dealers Association, and ourselves.
Okay.
So it's essentially the three businesses that are open on Saturdays.
Gotcha.
everybody else kind of closes down for the weekend, except for the three of us.
But I guess the biggest thing, or the thing we'd have to do to approve it, is to change the requirement which says it has to be a nonprofit or something like that to waive and allow a, like a better term, a citizens group?
Essentially, yes. It's,
to have a festival within your town. All right, well, that's two motions. So if you want to take action on... Now, I haven't made a motion. I'm just saying that that's what we need to look at.
You should wait until it files their application.
Yeah, I'd like to file the application, but in the meantime, why don't we have the attorney to look at the, or have someone to look at the procedure we set up to see what kind of wording would be needed to be changed that would allow private organization.
What we need to determine is if we as a council are willing to change that.
Right, right.
I don't think it'd be any problem giving approval to have the festival. The problem is, do we alter the requirement on being a profit or non-profit?
I can't recall. Does it right now give us the opportunity to decide those festivals or those events that fall outside of the confines of the document itself that gives us the ability to look at it case by case to approve it? Or is it pretty much either is or it isn't? Is there any gray area built into the document at this point?
I think what you do is put it's either a nonprofit or a civic oriented group. I mean,
right.
We do the same thing with the same, you know, Wilderness Days.
Yes.
You have vendors out there that are, you know, it's just like.
What I mean is, do we have to? We doesn't necessarily have to modify our document. We could just approve outside of it if we wanted to, or we could just modify it. It's either way.
That would be an attorney question, but I think it's pretty simple. You don't have to say or for profit. It's either nonprofit or civic oriented group.
Well, I think it's still early, so I'm sure Barry, you can come back with some recommendations for us.
Yeah, I think that's the best thing.
Yeah, that gives you time.
Yeah, I just need to know whether or not I can fill out the we've got the application thing, and thank you, by the way, for simplifying that. The version that you guys had last year, this year's, is a lot easier to fill out and doesn't require nearly as much guesswork.
let me suggest this. Come back with a recommendation, but in the meantime, you need to fill out the application, waive the 45 days like we did last time.
It's going to be well inside that.
Since it's July the 14th, okay,
so
you're okay. All right, we'll hear this at our next meeting, which is May 1st, I believe.
I think it's Thursday.
All right, thank you, Ms. Dorsett. Mr. Stipes, Mr. Hall, do you have?
We have another citizen to speak.
I'm sorry.
I just want to say how much I have enjoyed the new flags downtown and how pretty I think that they look. And then I want to thank whoever's responsible for having the water truck come by on Allegheny Street and wet down the road, because that has helped with the dust immensely. And if that can continue on until it gets done, we would certainly appreciate it. I have set my wicker settee out in hopes that the rain will try to wash some of the dust off of it. But thank you.
Ms. Turner, thank you, and I apologize for overlooking you.
That's
again.
Quite okay.
She knows me well enough to know over the years that sometimes I do forget. I don't think so. Mr. Stipes, Mr. Hall, Cemetery Committee report.
Yes, sir.
The Cemetery Committee met last Tuesday, April 10th. The purpose of the meeting was focused on an Eagle Scout project. There will be a kiosk being constructed there. The town is providing materials, and a fine young man and a team that he's organizing is going to be constructing it. And that's one issue we talked about, and one issue that Councilman Hall and myself wanted to bring up for council's consideration. The Cemetery Committee is seeking council support for the creation of a Cemetery Advisory Committee, something that's been discussed in the past, and since we don't meet on a regular basis, it's not an ad hoc committee, it is an active committee of council, but it does meet pretty infrequently. And Councilman Hall and I would like to seek council support before we decide exactly what we're going to, our specific recommendation, but we'd like to seek council support for the creation of a Cemetery Committee, Advisory Committee. The benefits of a committee, as we noted them, would be to draw on the expertise of members of the death care industry, clergy, and citizen members of our community regarding issues, policies, procedures, and operations, to have a dedicated focus group that meets on a regular basis with specialized expertise to consider, discuss, and advise the town council on both periodic or time-to-time issues as well as recurring issues related to town policy and the cemetery. And also providing a conduit and format for regular meetings of citizens. There are a number of issues that come up from time to time on there, and we have not delved into this in detail, but before doing so, we wanted to seek council support for that initiative, and then we'll come back with a specific recommendation.
And
Councilman Hall, whatever you want to add.
Well, I couldn't put it any better than what Mr. Stipe stated. I'm a new member of the Cemetery Committee, and frankly, I lack the expertise in that industry. I'm learning a lot about it, but I certainly think that not only myself, I could certainly benefit from having an advisory council, but a lot of the questions that may be posed to me, frankly, can probably be dealt with better by having members who are involved in the industry discuss it and then come back with recommendations to us. I don't know, we discussed just in passing about the makeup, and so I'm really not really prepared to present that tonight as to how we think we'll be made up, but again, personally, I feel like it could very well be the most useful committee that we have in the town, because not so many people are made aware of the goings-on at the cemetery. We have an advisory council here at the Aquatic Center. There's a lot of people who come to these doors, sit there at the rec center. We're all very familiar with the day-to-day operations. I don't believe we are when it comes to cemetery. Frankly, it's Adam, and then he's fielding probably every phone call that comes in regarding cemetery. So I think it would be very, very beneficial to have those individuals involved in the day-to-day operations that deal with that cemetery quite a bit to offer recommendations to us.
I would suggest that we make this an agenda item sometime in the future and get our ducks in a row with respect to exactly what would be the expectations of such a committee. Would they be a paid committee? How often would they meet? Is it
as needed? We're asking for at least an endorsement of the concept at this point. The endorsement of the concept, and we'll come back with specific recommendations.
I think that's, I believe that you people are looking over a cremation vault or something of that nature to be put in the cemetery.
These are the types of things.
Yeah, so I think a group of people to discuss things like that, which is somewhat of a major change, would be good.
It's a very sensitive topic.
That's right.
And I think it'd be best to have people who deal with that sensitive topic daily.
We learned the value, the potential value of this committee last year when we, a year and a half ago, when we came up with some rules that were well thought out and well-meaning and well-intentioned, but we stepped in a few cow pies with specific rules that we would have avoided had we had that input. But anyway.
Yeah, I echo what Mr. Stipes is saying. We're just looking for a tacit approval so we can move forward and start to maybe hammer home.
Well, you have my approval. It's very sensitive. So I think a group of people, not just professionals in the industry, but definitely get some citizens.
I think what we talked about is, of course, Councilman Hall and I would attend the meetings, alternate meetings, and have staff members, funeral home, not just in town, but also out of town that do business with the town or do business in the cemetery, clergy, members of the clergy. And then some citizens.
Isn't that large?
Absolutely.
And I couldn't imagine a better one. Ms. Carter's here today, who's been involved with the cemetery project for years.
Ms. Carter also serves on three other commissions and boards.
They're nothing compared to I can interrupt, to the cemetery that I worked 18 years. Yeah. I would really like to contribute.
And I believe, too, aren't they, the cemetery is involved in new plans here, because to lay out the areas of the cemetery that
yes,
are
there
not,
is, there
and is a, I think that would be a crucial thing, too, for a committee to be able to look at and take a vote on.
Yes. This year we are doing, there is a cemetery master plan being yeah. developed this year, which is very important, and it's a good time. Well, Councilman Hall and I feel like this is a good time to form a committee. And we'll come back with a more specific recommendation, but there's no sense talking about it if there's not support for that on council.
Right.
Yeah, we have talked when the town took over the cemetery about forming an advisory committee, and it never really got off the ground. We had talked about the need for it based on we have advisory committees for aquatics and recreation, but we just never did make a decision. So, if you want the committee to move forward just by nodding the head, say, yeah, go ahead, let's move forward, but bring it back as an agenda item real soon.
Well, I think it's a great concept, as long as we understand that is something that we as a town have. And they would be an advisory, but no, I would not see them as a decision-making.
It would be no different. The concept is similar to the recreation and the planning commission. That's simply an advisory committee.
Okay. Let's
move forward with that and look forward to it becoming an agenda item.
Thank you, Mayor.
All right, let's move on then to the town manager's report.
I have several public hearings to set. We've received a street vacation request for a portion of Red Oak Drive. And I'd like to set that public hearing for the 15th of May. These are different dates, so I'll take action on that one.
To move.
Second.
A motion and a second to set that hearing for May 15th.
What was that again? The Red Oak
Drive. Close a portion of Red Oak Drive, about 200 feet of it.
Thank you.
All in favor of setting that on the agenda for May 15th, please say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
A request for a carnival. Planning Commission will have their public hearing on May the 7th, so we'd like to set our public hearing for June the 5th, and that's for carnival at the mall. They want to also like to take action on that night, because they want to start the carnival on the 14th of June. So start setting up 11th, carnival on the 14th, so.
Any way we could end it?
At
the week before?
I don't think so, Karen.
You could have a public hearing the week before. Just won't
2 weeks
plan,
before.
Just won't have a planning commission recommendation.
Okay.
You know, comment.
15th of May, then.
Comment concerning the Planning Commission, for the last three meetings has been 100% attendance, and such, and it's really been doing a great job, really looking into things, and good attendance and good support.
All right, so we're moving the carnival request to May 15th.
Yes, sir. They don't have to vote.
All right, and then they'll need time to do the advertising and setting up. That's going to be at downtown Christiansburg.
At the mall.
I didn't hear that part. You know who's going to sponsor it?
Damn sure it ain't the Kiwanis Club.
Yep. Kiva Works. But I don't know who the local, if there's anybody who's locally sponsoring.
Okay.
Will.
All right. May 15th. Did we take a vote on that? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. What else, Mr. Town Manager?
We'll get clarification here.
Mayor, did we have a motion and a second on that?
So moved.
Second.
Apologize.
I thought we did, I'm sorry.
Okay.
We do now?
Yes.
After the fact.
No, we voted again. And that's fine. But that's chicken, too.
I believe it'd be the same vote.
I'm reconsidering.
I'm reconsidering.
All right, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, no. All right, thank you.
Next two would be for June the 5th. Condition use request by PNR Financing Limited Partner. Oh, okay. Never mind. That would be, back up. A condition use permit request by David Otos for major home occupation for powder coating at 625 Walters Drive in the R1 single family residential district. And then the second one for June the 5th would be council's intention to adopt an ordinance regarding Chapter 30 zoning of Christiansburg Town Code in regards to definitions, provisions for condition use permits, parking, setbacks, permitted uses, height regulations, townhouse regulations, site plan review, and variances. But those postponed to June 5th.
So moved. June 5th, second. Motion and a second to set those public hearings. June 5th, please, everyone say aye if you're approved.
Aye.
Aye. No if you don't approve. You want to stop?
No,
we're not. All right, we're ready. Go ahead.
Okay, next thing, I've had some requests that I believe the street committee might need to review. One of them is installing street lights at Craig Mountain, and the other one is discussion about possible private street.
Albert Lane?
Yeah, Albert Lane.
This does not relate to that subdivision back there.
It does, yes.
Okay. So, yeah, we'll definitely take that out. Right. Well, I mean, yeah. Okay.
I'd like the street committee to study those. I'll request that.
Yeah, before it comes back to us, let's let the street committee take a look at it.
Reminder that BML town section meetings on Friday, May 11th in Marion. Have heard anyone would like to go, do want to go, get you signed up this week. One of us will drive down there. Anybody else is going?
I had planned to go, but I'm not going to be able to go.
The last thing I have is I'd like to request a vacation on the 7th and 8th of June.
Yeah.
Well, 2 days.
I'd like to bring my resignation. My granddaughter's going back to Africa. I want to take her to the airport.
Good.
I really don't want to take her to the airport, but I'd like to be there when she goes.
So you're going to take a couple days off, Mr. Town Manager.
That's all.
Nothing else? No bills to pay? No. Yes, we have Thursday night. We'll be back in Town Hall. What time do you want to meet? 6 o'clock. It's already been advertised. 6 o'clock Thursday evening. We'll see you then. Anything else?
I've got one question about when Blake came about the, I believe he's at the street committee as well.
Sleepy Hollow.
Any decision made for Sleepy Hollow?
We are developing the, we're having a workshop. I guess we didn't have a street committee report on the agenda. The street committee is meeting on April 30th to develop some guidelines, or what do we call it?
To work on development.
Traffic calming.
Policy on traffic calming throughout town. And shortly following that, we expect to take action on Sleepy Hollow.
Thank you.
And we do have some ideas. Yeah, we have some good ideas, I think.
Put those bump outs in there.
This has been a very productive meeting, folks. I know that the students and coaches appreciated the recognition, and Kurt Litton had to leave to go to the school board office, but Kurt is the athletic director at Christiansburg High School, and he was named last week as the Administrator of the Year for the state of Virginia. So, congratulations.